Welcome back, everybody.
欢迎大家回来。
Jonathan was just reading my slide to me and helping me understand what it says.
因为刚好这一个 PPT 是全部中文，所以我帮他翻译一下他的 PPT 哈。
So he may be helping me with this more than even more, right?
所以我们一起来谈这个亲密行为的过程。
Okay, so we're going to wrap up with our last session, and it has been so much fun to be with you.
今天这一堂是我们最后的一堂哦。其实，在我们这三天当中，真的是跟大家在一起，非常的开心。
So I'm going to talk just a little bit about the lovemaking cycle.
我要跟大家分享的就是这样的一个亲密行为或者是做爱的一个过程啊。
And then I'll spend the rest of our time doing a Q&A.
然后剩余的时间呢，我们就会尝试做 Q&A， 回答大家的问题。
So when we talk about the lovemaking cycle, it includes creating an atmosphere.
所以当我们要进入到做爱的这样一个过程的里面，其实第一个步骤其实是要营造一个气氛。
So it requires a mature marriage. We were just talking in our group and.We had several of us who'd been married over 25 years, and then a young couple who are more newlyweds, and we talked about how really you need to be 50 years old before you learn how to really make love.
那其实呢，我们接着讲怎么样能够营造那个气氛呢？刚刚在我们的小组里面，其实我们有谈到，其实一个成熟的婚姻关系对那个真正的做爱的那一个过程，其实有很大的帮助。我们说，你真的要成为一个做爱的。不能用高手，但是真的会彼此满足对方的话，你要五十岁以后才会真正的懂怎么样彼此爱对方啊。
So we encourage this young couple to keep practicing, because the more you practice, the better you get at this.
我们就鼓励这一对年轻的夫妇们就继续的操练，继续的学习，终有一天会突破的。
I hope that for those of you who are married, that when you're 90 years old, you're still making love to each other.
我要鼓励我们当中已婚的夫妻们啊，如果在像我们期待你九十岁的时候，仍然在彼此热恋做爱中。
So to really make love to each other, it requires a lot of maturity.
所以要真的彼此，我们讲的不只是性行为而已，而是做爱的时候需要很大的一个成熟度在我们的生命里面。
You've got to create the right atmosphere.
你必须要营造一个正确、合适的氛围。
And so parents put a lock on your bedroom door.
所以我们做父母的，记得你的主卧室一定要有锁门的机制。
It helps if you know the kids aren't going to come barging in any moment.
如果你可以知道孩子不可以任何时候闯进来，其实会给你们很大的安全感。
Tom and Kathy said that when their son was young, one day they were making love in their bedroom, and their son came bursting in the door, and he said, "What are you guys doing?"
Tom 跟 Kathy 就说，有一趟他们还年轻的时候呢，孩子还小的时候呢，他们有一天在做爱的时候呢，孩子就冲进到房间里面说，你们在干嘛？
So Tom said, "We're wrestling."
然后 Tom 就说我们在摔跤。
So their son jumped on top of them and joined the wrestling match.
好的，而且跳上床，我们一起三个来摔跤吧。
So privacy is always a good idea.
所以那个隐私度是很重要的。
You also have to have energy.
你必须还有体力啊，说真的。
I think that can be one of the biggest obstacles to married couples making love to each other.
其实已婚的，我们夫妻，我们在夫妻在婚姻当中，其实体力这个东西其实是一个很大的，很大让我们没有办法享受的一个东西。
So if we're going to have energy, we've got to make it a priority.
所以如果你要有好的体力，你必须让性生活，让夫妻之间的这个做爱，成为你们的婚姻当中的优先次序。
In the Song of Solomon, God celebrates a husband and a wife making love to each other.
在雅各书里面，我们很清楚看见神欢庆丈夫跟他的妻子之间这样的一个亲密愉悦的关系。
Many believe the passage in the Song of Solomon, where it said, "Drink, O friends, drink deeply."
很多的人认为在雅各书里面。的经文里面讲到说，你来喝饮与这个泉源。
That's God celebrating, and applauding, like, yes, this husband and wife are making love to each other.
就是当神在那边好像是拍掌，在那边欢庆，当丈夫跟他的妻子在做爱的关系当中，神有多开心。